Okay, so yes, remember at the end of yesterday's dialogue, Charles said that he would introduce Megan to some of his friends. And it seems he's making good on that promise. He's doing what he said he would, because this article, which of course, like yesterday, is a dialogue, It begins with the sentence that sets the scene, and it says, Charles brings Megan to meet his friends.
昨天呢，提到最后。Charles 呢要介绍他的朋友给 Megan， 所以呢，今天 Charles 就非常的遵守承诺，他就带 Megan 去介给他们的朋友认识啦。And now he has to introduce Megan to his friends.
That's right. I'm a little more nervous.
Why?
Because, well, if you're meeting someone new one-on-one, it's a little bit, you know, not so scary.
Right.
But when there's a big group of people,
yeah.
and you know, you kind of feel a bit more like you're on show. Like, hey, everyone,
yeah,
I'm
and
fun.
And you're the outsider. Right?
Yeah, and they all know each other. Mm-hmm. But if she continues doing the great job that she's doing and just relaxes and just acts, you know, normal, just be yourself, basically, is the advice I would give. And Charles is helping out, too,
yes. By
being very gracious and polite and kind. He says, hey, guys, this is Megan. I told you about her, remember? So he just sort of introduces her to the whole group. And then he also makes Megan feel a little bit better because, you know, he's letting her know that he's already told his friends about her. I told you, my friends, about her, Megan. Remember? Okay. And to that, tell is the first word power word for today. It's a verb. It's spelled T-E-L-L. T-E-L-L. Tell.All right, when you're telling something to someone, you are giving information to them. One person is probably speaking, and the other person is doing most of the listening. You can tell someone a story, you can tell someone information, you can tell someone something important that they have to know, but basically you're saying something. You could also be writing it, but we often use it for speaking. And this information is important or interesting or fun or, you know, entertaining, and the other person be like, what? Tell me, I'm listening. What? No way. Really? Oh my God. What'd you do? What? Wow. And then what happened? Wow, that's great. Great story. Thanks very much. Because someone was telling me the story. For example, Amy told me she wants to go to Japan this summer. That's what she said to me. And then I told her, I want to go too. Amy told me she wants to go to Japan this summer. Thanks for that, Amy.
Tell 是告诉，这是一个动词。我们特别注意到它的三态是不规则变化 ，tell, told, told。像我们看到例句是 Amy told me， 她告诉我今年夏天她要去日本。So you tell somebody about something or somebody， 就是你可以接两个受词。这个啊，我们看到文章也是说。告诉你，跟你们介绍过 Megan。除了告诉以外啊 ，tell 你也可以，比如说 tell a story， 说一个故事 ，or tell a secret， 说一个秘密。不过 tell 呢，它是一定要接对象，所以后面一定要接受词啦。So Charles must have told them about Megan.、
Mm-hmm.
And who are Charles' friends?
Well, we're going to introduce one. We're going to meet one, and she's going to introduce herself right here. It's Crystal. Crystal is one of Charles' friends, and she's also nice. She says, welcome to our school.
Hopefully,
she says it in a nice way. Welcome to our school, not welcome to our school. Like that, because that wouldn't...
Who would do that?
I don't know. Maybe Crystal really likes Charles, and Charles kind
of... Let's not get there.
Who knows?
Yeah.
No, but I'm sure she's very polite and kind, being a friend of Charles, who's also nice. So she just says with a smile, welcome to our school.
Yes.
Nice thing to say.
Normal version.
A normal, non-dramatic, non-rom-com version.
No, 我们看到这个最先讲话的 Crystal, 她就说 welcome, 欢迎来到我们的学校啦。我们可以用 welcome to somewhere, 就是来到某个地方。And you can always say this when somebody visits you.
Sure,
right?
Yeah.
比如说 welcome to my house.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
It's lovely.
Yeah. Check it out.
It's great.
Or welcome to the country.
Oh, thank you. I've been here many years, but thank you. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you very much, weird lady. Anyway, let's get back to the article. Dave is another one of Charles' friends, and he says, you can sit here, Megan. So maybe he moves over or stands up and gives her a seat. What a gentleman.
Super nice.
Very nice of him, yes.
还有 Dave, 他非常的绅士啦。他说，哎，你可以坐这边。他可能是移了位置啊，或是站起来。通常如果来到一个陌生的环境，你可能会，哎，不知道这边的规矩。So you might not know what to do, where to sit.
Sure.
So Dave is being very nice.
Yes.
He's showing how they do things,、mm-hmm. right? So, of course, Megan says...
No!
No?
She says, thanks, which is what you would say when someone offers you something, when someone is being nice, polite, and friendly to you, and offers you something, you say thanks.
Yeah, 其实大家都还蛮友善的，所以 Megan 呢也就跟大家说谢谢 thanks.
All right, and to keep the、conversation going and to learn more about、Megan, Crystal asks her this question. So, tell us a little more about yourself. So, you know, give us some information. Where are you from? What do you do? What do you like? That kind of thing.
刚来到新的环境，大家都不认识你嘛，所以呢，可能 they would expect you to introduce yourself first.、Mm-hmm. 这时候呢，就可能就是比较、口语的用法，就是说哦，告诉我们多告诉我们一些你的事情。所以 Crystal 就说，关于多跟我们说说关于的事情。This is when youlet others know more、mm-hmm. about you and、mm-hmm. to start with more conversations too.
Yeah.
再讲一些关于自己的事情，大家也就比较了解你，甚至就可以开启别的话题。So what do we know about Megan?
Well, this is of course where you would say more information. You don't have to say, well, I was born on a Tuesday at 8:15 in the morning.
Midnight.
The doctor's name was Dr. Solomon. And、no, you don't have to give them your whole life story. But some interesting basic information. So Megan says, let's see.I guess I study a lot, all right? So she's letting them know that、mm-hmm. she studies, she's a serious student, and she works hard at that. That's interesting.
Megan 就回说、欸、让我想想看、哦、She studies a lot,、mm-hmm. 她读很多书 That's impressive. What else?
Well, then Crystal asks her another good question. Do you have any hobbies? Maybe Crystal's saying, well, we all study a lot. We're at school, we're students.
This is boring.
Yeah, let's get to something a little more personal, a、mm-hmm. little bit more just about Megan. And hobbies, that's a great place to go to. Do you have any hobbies? Hobby is our second word power word for today. It's a noun. It's spelled H-O-B-B-Y. H-O-B-B-Y. Hobby. Okay, a hobby is basically something that you enjoy doing in your free time. Often hobbies are things you might learn or get good at. They often require activities where you use your hands. Gardening is a hobby. Playing music is a hobby.Cooking is a hobby, or making clothes is also a hobby. Hobbies are something that you enjoy, that give you pleasure, that are lots of fun. For example, Henry's hobby is building models. He likes to make small airplanes. Henry's hobby is building models. He likes to make small airplanes.
Hobby 就是兴趣嗜好，就是平常没事喜欢做的事情。像例句是 Henry 喜欢组装模型，所以这个 Crystal 呢就先问 Megan 说：“哎，那你的嗜好是什么呢？”
All right. Well, what are her hobbies? Megan tells everyone. She says, "I play tennis to stay in shape. I also collect comics." All right,、mm. two very good hobbies.、
Yeah.
Tennis is the first one that we come across there. It's also a word power word. It's spelled T-E-N-N-I-S, T-E-N-N-I-S. As I mentioned, tennis is a noun, and it's a sport. It's the name of a sport. It involves hitting a little ball over a net using something that you hold in your hand called a racket. The balls are often, you know, about the size of a baseball. They're yellow, they're soft, and people play it generally one-on-one or two groups of two. That's doubles tennis, or singles tennis is just one-on-one. It's a summer sport, and if you know names like Novak Djokovic or Serena Williams or places like Wimbledon,You probably know what I'm talking about. Actually, there are some very good Taiwanese tennis players these days, including some women's teams that are just fantastic. Great sport to play, fun sport to watch on TV if you like watching things go...Like this, back and forth. Very entertaining and also good exercise. For example, do you want to play tennis later? It's a nice day out. Do you want to play tennis later? It's a nice day out.
Tennis 是网球、mm. 另外、yes. 台湾比较流行的是 badminton.
That's popular here.、Mm. Maybe because Taiwan's really hot.
Yeah, and it's smaller.
That's true too.、Yeah. But they're similar sports.
It is.、Mm. 就跟这个羽毛球一样。然后呢在、比如说我们打球啊等等运动、mm. 英文我们就会搭配 play 这个动词。So play tennis, play badminton 都可以用 play. Megan 呢就说、欸、她平常是喜欢打网球 to stay in shape, 保持身体健康。I've heard that tennis is really a good exercise.
Yeah.
It works out all your muscles.
It does.
And she also collects comics.
That was her other hobby. hobby. Yeah, that's not an active hobby. That's a more relaxing hobby. Mm-hmm. Collecting is just gathering a lot of things that are similar to make a collection, a big grouping of organized things. And in this case, she's not collecting coins or stamps or things like that. She's collecting comics. Comic, it's our last word, power word. It's spelled C-O-M-I-C. C-O-M-I-C, comic.All right, what is a comic? A comic is a magazine or a book that tells a story using words, but mainly also using pictures. You'll have artists draw many, many, many little pictures. Sometimes the people in the comic will speak. Sometimes the pictures will just tell the story, and it's just a way of telling a story in a more visual way, using pictures more than words. There are comics of all types. Some of the well-known Western ones would be Batman, Spider-Man, Superman, Wonder Woman. Of course, manga are Japanese comics. So if you like Doraemon or One Piece or Conan or anything like that, then you might like manga, Japanese comics. But either way, it's a book or a magazine that tells stories with pictures and words. For example, I like to read this comic. It's an exciting story. I like to read this comic.It's an exciting story.
Megan 说她还喜欢做什么？也喜欢收集漫画 comic， 也就是 comic books， 漫画书啦。例句我们看到 read 加这个动词搭配，就是 read the comic， 喜欢读这部漫画。So Megan's hobbies are playing tennis.And collecting comics.
That's right. One she can do outside and one she can do inside on a rainy day. And Dave, remember Charles's friend Dave says, no way, I have the same hobbies too.
Wow.
Well, they have that in common. And of course, he says, no way, because you say that when you're surprised and you're like, no way, that's true. No way I believe you. That must be impossible because it's so surprising. But I'm sure it's true.
Dave 这时候就说不是吧不会吧我们用 no way 表示不可置信不敢相信为什么不敢相信呢因为 Dave 说他 he has the same hobbies
he does
他有一模一样喜欢做一样的事情 wow things have worked out for Megan
yeah
she's making some new friends with same hobbies
that's right she can go and play comics while listening to tennisWait, doing it the other way. Anyway, she can enjoy her hobbies with Dave at least, and I'm sure many of her other new friends. Mm-hmm. And then Charles, remember Charles? He says, I have an idea. Ding! Let's get together this weekend and show Megan our city. Well, that's very nice.
Super
nice. So they're going to plan a little activity after school on the weekend. They're going to basically be Megan's tour guides and take them to some of her favorite places.All around the town.
Charles 这时候就有个主意了，他说：“哎、欸、，Let's get together， 大家周末的时候聚在一起，让带 Megan 就是认识一下他们的城市。”
And Crystal's down with it. Crystal's excited. She'll join them too. She says, "That sounds great. Great plan. Great idea." And then, as another way of staying in touch, she says to Megan, "Megan." Add me on Facebook. So, of course, everyone has a phone these days with the Facebook app. You can add them there, and then they'll be connected. They'll be able to chat and talk and call each other and share cute emojis.
Add 在这里呢是指新增 add people on Facebook means to become friends.
That's right.
Or you can to friend you, 就是加你为朋友嘛。另外呢，这因为现在是二十一世纪了嘛 ，It's 21st century, so everybody.That's how they break the ice.
That's right. You can add them
on Facebook,
maybe Line, WhatsApp, something like that.
等等的这些 social media.
Exactly right. So Megan takes out her phone, and you can imagine she's opening the app and then typing in typing in Crystal's name.And sending off a friend request.
当然，这时候就是手机时间了。But before you take out your phones, let's go do today's magic box.
I have an app for that too.
Wow.